Salutations, subscribers and newcomers. My goal for this episode is to kill the antlion with Friedrich and obtain the Lazy Deserter blueprint. The Lazy Deserter is useless in a solo world because it takes two players to operate, but if any of my Steam friends join the server, it'll let us teleport to each other. When I'm hosting a server, I like to have one Lazy Deserter at the Florid Postern and another Lazy Deserter in the main base. That way I can bring newcomers to safety as soon as they've chosen their character, instead of forcing them to make a long, arduous hike through the summer sun, the spring rain, or the winter cold. Before I fight Antlion, I want to craft some desert goggles to protect me from her sandstorm. It's possible to beat her without desert goggles. Eboy Cheese shows how to do it in a fantastic speedrun that I'll link in the description. But I'm not sure that will be possible for me. This may come as a surprise to some of you, but Antlion typically gives me more trouble than any of the other surface bosses, even Bee Queen and the Shadow Pieces. This is mostly because I don't rotate my camera often enough while kiting, which causes problems in many situations, but it's particularly crippling against Antlion because the pattern to kite her efficiently requires specific small movements in a tight circle. As soon as I lose my footing, Antlion traps me in a cage of spikes and I eat hundreds of damage. I need the desert goggles to be sure that I can see where I'm moving. Adding to this worry is the fact that I've never actually fought Antlion on an ornery beeflow before. I've fought her with Wendy on foot, but that's a very different matter. On foot, Wendy can tank Antlion's damage with log suits and healing, but to heal Friedrich, I need to dismount, and unlike Dragonfly, Antlion never really gives you a moment to breathe. If Friedrich gets low, I'll probably just have to retreat, but I might not even have the option to retreat if I'm trapped in a cage of spikes. I'll bring the pan flute just in case things get really sketchy. Anyway, to craft desert goggles, you need two blueprints that can only be found by fishing them out of the Oasis Lake, so that's what I'll be doing for the next few days. Riveting stuff. Enjoy! Antlion is attacking me with a localized earthquake. There are three ways to deal with this. One is to simply leave your base until the earthquake ends so that none of your structures are damaged. Another is to feed Antlion some of your rocks, meat, and trinkets, but I don't recommend that because, much like in real life, it's usually counterproductive to reward shakedowns and extortion racketeers. The time and resources that it takes to pay tribute to Antlion tend to be a lot less efficient than the first solution. The third solution is to simply kill the antlion, and that's always my favorite option as soon as it becomes feasible. This is my first time fighting Antlion on an ornery beefalo, but it's not my first time fighting Antlion as Wendy, so I know a useful trick here. Antlion's sand spikes are coded as environmental damage, and Abigail is completely immune to most forms of environmental damage, so this is the one boss fight where she'll never be banished. If she wants to, Wendy can just sit on the sidelines eating popcorn while Abby does all the heavy lifting. But I made a commitment to involve Friedrich in every surface boss fight in this world, and I'm not about to go back on that commitment now. This is what I was talking about earlier. I have a lot of trouble not getting stuck in cages like this as the arena fills up with more and more spikes. Friedrich's fallen below 200 health. I'm going to let Abby take over for a little bit while I run him around the edge of the arena so he can regenerate. I'm overheating. The only sources of protection I brought from the summer heat were my thermal stone and my umbrella, and I kept needing to swap the umbrella out for the desert goggles so that I could see where I was going. I definitely underprepared for this. You win this round, Antlion. Thank you. Round two, you jerk. Some things never change. At least I'm not overheating this time. Hey, looks like Abby finished her for me. That nighttime damage bonus put in some work. Antlion always spawns in the same spot every summer, so I'm leaving some of her loot behind to market in case I want to set up any preparations in advance next year, like cobblestone flooring or a pig or bunny village to help me out. That's it for this episode, folks. Next time I'll be fighting Yukus and Berger. I'll also be making my first trip into the ruins for ancient gear. Later!